In this tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how to use the Generic Online Annotation Tool, or GOAT, to contribute gene function annotations. In order to contribute your annotations, you'll need to have an ORCiD ID. This is so we can attribute your contributions to you. So if you don't have an ORCiD ID, please go ahead and create one first. So you click on the Login to ORCiD link, sign in with your credentials, and then you can go to the submission button on the homepage and start entering in your information. Because GOAT is a paper-based curation tool, you'll first be prompted to enter in the PubMed ID or the digital object identifier for the paper that you wish to curate. And you'll see that once the information is validated, there's a checkbox and you can make sure that you've entered in the proper identifier for your publication. Going into the next section, you'll enter in the gene identifiers for all of the genes in the paper that you wish to curate. You can enter in a UniProt ID for any species, AGI locus IDs for Arabidopsis thaliana, or RNA Central IDs for any species. Once that identifier has been entered and it's validated, you'll see a green checkbox. You can enter in also information about any gene symbols or full names. And this is useful if this is the first time a gene has been named. This is a way to make sure that that information gets into the public domain and associated to your gene. So by clicking on the Add Another Gene, you can add as many genes to this list as you would like. Once you're done adding in all your genes, you can begin to add annotations. Choose the aspect that you would like to annotate to from the drop-down menu. So there's the three different gene ontology aspects: component, biological process, and molecular function. Select the gene that you want to curate from the list. Enter in the term, and you'll see that there's an autocomplete function both for the term as well as the method. The method is the experimental method from the publication that supports the assertion that you're making. So as you go through and add annotations, different subsets of terms will be available to you depending on the different ontology aspect that you choose. So try to choose the best evidence that you can, the best match to the evidence that you can from the drop-down list. You'll notice that in some cases, depending on the experimental evidence that you select, you may be prompted to add additional information. So in this example, I'm going to make an annotation to the biological process mRNA export from the nucleus. And the experimental evidence supporting that assertion is a double mutant phenotypic evidence. And because it's a double mutant, according to the gene ontology rules, I need to provide the gene identifier for the other mutated gene. So you do that here, and then you're done. In addition to curating gene ontology and plant ontology annotations, you can also curate protein-protein interactions. And that's simply a matter of choosing the two different gene products from the list and the experimental method for the interaction. You can also annotate and add comments. So these are sort of unstructured statements. If this is for an Arabidopsis gene, then these comments can be used to provide summaries, curated summaries for genes that would be visible in TAIR. Once you're done adding all of your annotations, you can then click on the link on the lower right to review your submission. And this is your opportunity to make sure that all the information that you've entered is correct. And if it's not, then you can go back and edit the information. You can click on the links to the GO terms to read the definitions to make sure that it's the term that you meant to curate. And then you can enter in your email address, and we'll just use that to contact you if we have questions about your submissions as we go through the process of curating. So all submissions are reviewed by a curator before they're approved and then shared in the public domain. So we hope that you are able to use this tool, and if you have any questions, please contact us at curator@arabidopsis.org.